The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Escorted to the ring by Paul.
You know, Brain, at any time, don't be surprised if you see Sid Justice come out of the woodwork and do a number on this guy.
I know. It could happen anytime.
And he deserves it. And so does that other piece of garbage, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Well, this Monday night on primetime, I'm going to have the greatest bodybuilder probably in the history of the world. Lou Ferrigno's going to be on, Rowdy Roddy Piper, and Jake the Snake Roberts. And Piper better be careful, because you know what Jake did to Elizabeth. Maybe he just doesn't like people in skirts.
Yeah. He's got enough enemies right now. He won't want to fool around with a hot rod, I'll tell you that. A couple of back jumpers.
You know, you got to be turning your back all the time here, looking around. You don't know if Jake's going to come out with something. You don't know if Justice is going to appear. You don't know what's going to happen.
Why would you deliberately want to make an enemy of someone here in the World Wrestling Federation?
Because you can.
Because you can.
Yep. They just don't care.
Why would you want to turn the greatest day in anyone's life into a day of infamy?
Because you're a very disturbed person. That's the only thing I can come up with.
Jake is very disturbed.
Oh, yes. See, that's why Jake has never been close to anybody.
He's been bit too many times.
That could be. Maybe that's right. But see, Jake's never been close to anybody. The reason these two get along is because Jake found somebody who's as sick as him.
You're sick, all right.
Oh, you aren't kidding. I like it. Jake's my friend. And Mr. Bear outside the ring, he's controlling everything. Does a lot more than just carry an urn and body bag, I bet.
He'll have to pay just like the rest of them, right?
What makes you think they're going to have to pay? Maybe everybody else is going to pay this time. Who really knows? Look at those eyes. Look at those eyes.
You know, sooner or later, you're going to have to meet these guys face to face, not face to back.
Whoa! Look at that!
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to the big guy, Sid Justice. Here's what's on his mind.
See, I told you, Undertaker, you and Snake Roberts, that I stood for justice. Just as the same as I stood in between you and Miss Elizabeth the night that you came down and you tried to smother her dreams out. With you, Snake Roberts, and you, Undertaker, any time that we meet, I can promise you only one thing, that justice will be served.
I think you're going to need a bigger body bag.
I think you're going to need a bigger ring.
Well,
it won't even go in the ring, probably. Look at that. I don't see where a ring could hold those two. I don't see any place. They're just going to fight wherever they want to fight. Justice will prevail, huh? Justice will be served.
Mm-hmm. It certainly will be. Here comes Pile Driver City. Oh, he got planted.
Boy, didn't he? That's not even a pile driver. That's the tombstone. What a tattoo he has on his arm. Did you see that?
I didn't get a real good look at it.
I saw it in the hallway the other day, and it's all kinds of people with shrouds and hoods on and sickles and tombstones, I think.
Sick stuff, right?
Yeah, sick stuff. It's got sick stuff tattooed on.
Grace.
Well, pal, it's over. He never changes expression from the time he leaves the dressing room to the time he goes to bed, probably. He's always got the same expression. It's like there's no blood flowing through him.
Yes. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
Well, Chris, you got suplexed. Now you got nailed from the top rope. And now you got speared with the tombstone.
Talk about sick people.
Mm.
Oh, that ain't insulting. victory. Give me a break.
He's looking at you, Monsoon.
Looking at me? He better be looking over his shoulder for a much taller guy. Here we go to the event center. Take it away.
This bag's for you.